previous videos, you learned what is Active Directory and how to install it on Server 2022 with graphical user interface. If you have not watched it yet, you can put this video on pause and click the link on top of your screen. In this video, you will learn how to install Active Directory domain services on Server Core and promote the server to a domain controller. We will create our first forest and domain. Let's start. There are a few methods to install a domain controller on Server Core. In this video, I'm going to show you the fastest, which is the easiest method to install and create a domain on a Server Core. And then, once the installation is finished, we conduct a series of tests. First, you need to make sure to set a static IP address for your Server Core and set the DNS address same as the server IP. I have a separate video on basic configurations of Server Core, including IP, time, and other settings. If you need to learn how to configure a Server Core and complete the basic configuration, click the link on top of your screen to watch that video. After you have completed the basic configuration of Server Core, you can start the installation process. Let's start by taking a look at Windows features required for domain services. Type get-windows feature star domain star. This command will list all the features that have the word domain in it. As you can see, Active Directory domain services role is listed, but it's not installed. This role is the first requirement for promoting a server to a domain controller. To install it, type install -windows feature -include all sub features -include management tools and hit enter. By adding -include all sub features, you are telling your core server to automatically install any other features that are required for this role. And by including include management tools, you will make sure to install any other feature that might be needed for this role. Wait a few seconds for the process to complete the installation. Depending on your computer speed, it might take a few minutes. Once the setup is complete, you can check the setup by running get-windows feature star domain star again. You can see the role is listed and is now installed. Now that you have installed the role, you can start promoting the server to a domain controller. As you have noticed in all my videos, I show you how to find the commands that you need to complete a task. Similarly, to find the commandlets for installing a domain, type get-command-module-adds-deployment. This will list all the commands that are in adds-deployment PowerShell module, all the commands related to deploying a domain. Looking at the commands, you can see that installing a new forest will stand out. That's our starting point. Because you don't have any domains or forests, you need to start by creating your first forest. Optionally, check the syntax needed to run this command. Type get-help install-adds forest and look for the options and parameters for this command. Let's start creating your first forest and domain. Type install-adds forest-domain name and put your desired domain name in quotes, then hit enter. In this example, I'm using lab.local as my domain name. System will prompt you to enter the password for Active Directory Safe Mode Recovery. This is not your administrator's password. This is a password that you need to remember and use in situations that you want to use Active Directory Safe Mode Restore. I will create more videos about Active Directory soon. So make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to be notified when the content is released. Next, system will inform you that the computer needs to be restarted and ask for your permission. You can type yes to answer yes or type A to say yes to all the questions. After this step, system will start installing all the required roles and services and promote the computer to a domain controller. Because this is the first domain in the forest and you don't have any DNS servers, system will automatically install and configure DNS on the same server. Depending on your server speed, this step might take several minutes. Once the setup is completed, system will notify you and restart the server. After the restart, you can see you have successfully installed the domain controller. Please note that domain controllers take longer to load. In order to test the installation, log into your core server, and on the sconfig page, look at the domain status. By looking at the option 1, you'll see it is listed as a domain. Now that you have your domain as your ultimate test scenario, let's join a computer to this domain. In this demo, I use another Windows server with graphical user interface as my client to join to this domain. With this, I can even start managing my core server remotely by using that server. Log into your client machine and make sure it is on the same network as your domain controller. Then assign a static IP address to your client in the same network as your domain controller. As the last step for IP configuration, set the DNS address IP of your client to the IP address of your domain controller. This is where the system automatically installed DNS services. I will have more detailed videos about DNS. Now that you've finished the IP assignments to your client, let's do some connection and name resolution checks. From your client computer, open command prompt and ping your core server IP address. If you see a reply from your server core, it means your connections are good. If you see request timeout and your client could not ping your core, make sure both VMs are connected to the same network and they both have the same IP range. For the next test, ping your domain name. In my case, I will ping lab.local. If you see the reply, that means your connection is great and the DNS name resolution is working. If your system could not resolve the name and replied host not found, check your DNS IP and make sure you are using the core server's IP address. If the server could resolve the name but could not ping the name, then check firewall ports, network connectivity, and IP addresses one more time. To join the computer to the domain, open Server Manager and go to Local Server page. From Local Server page, click on Workgroup. System will open System Property page. In Computer Name tab, hit Change. On the opened window, under Member of section, select Domain, enter your domain name and click OK. In the next window, enter the credential for your domain and hit OK. Make sure to use domain credentials. In this example, my domain administrator account is called administrator and my domain name is lab.local. My domain net bias name is lab. So for username, I can either type lab/administrator or I could use administrator@lab.local. Enter password and hit OK. System will join to the domain and confirms this by showing a pop-up window saying, "Welcome to the domain." Click OK and you will need to restart the computer. After the restart, make sure to log in with your domain username and password. In this demo, I will use lab/administrator. By going to the server manager again, I can see the computer is joined to the domain now. Now, let's take our remote administration one step further and add server core to server manager on this server. For that, click on All Servers, go to Manage menu and select Add Servers. On the open box, type in your server core name and click Find Now. Select your server core, add it to the list and click OK. System will contact server core, collect information and then add it to the list. After a few moments, you will notice more options are showing up in your server manager. To be able to do remote administrations on your server core using the graphical user interface of this server, you need consoles and admin tools. To install them, simply go to Manage and select Add Roles or Features. Select Role Based on the first page and click Next. On the next page, select your server and click Next. Make sure to select your current server, not your core. This is the server that you want to install the administrative tools on. On the next page, click Next without selecting any roles. We don't need any roles for remote administrations. We only need consoles. All the consoles are available under administrative tools. On the next page, browse through the features and open Remote Server Administrative Tools. Under Role Administrative Tools, select ADDS and ADDS tools. Then scroll down and select DNS tools and finally hit next. This will install all the required administrative tools for Active Directory and DNS. Wait for the process to finish. After the setup is complete, go to the Tools menu and open Active Directory Users and Computers. You can see that you can now completely manage your domain controller from this console. Each computer has a local user called administrator, and the default domain user is called administrator as well. This can be confusing for some users, and sometimes users will forget to log in with the domain account and will face authentication issues. To avoid this, simply create a new user and provide admin rights to it. In this example, I will create a new organizational unit and a new user. I will then assign the highest level of permissions to my user by adding it to domain admins and enterprise administrator group. Lastly, open DNS tool from Tools menu and check your DNS records. Once you open the tool, simply select the name of your core server to connect and remotely manage it. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel for more videos like this. Make sure to hit the bell icon to be notified when the new content is released. Also, leave a comment in the comment section down below and let me know what other subjects would you like to learn. Thank you for watching. And I hope to see you on the next video.